And House Majority Leader Eric Cantor joins me now. You're unveiling a new website and Facebook app called cosponsor.gov. I'll get to that in a second, but first I want to talk about some of the things in the news. There was a big hearing on Capitol Hill today about the IRS. Also, some back and forth with the White House between the chairman of the House Oversight Committee, Daryl Issa, who called Jay Carney a paid liar, calling the White House spokesman a paid liar. I'm wondering your reaction to that, because some Republicans in the Senate and your equivalent, the House Minority Leader, Steny Hoyer, has said that Daryl Issa ought to apologize.
Look, Daryl Issa, Dave Camp, and the number of other chairmen that we have that are involved in the oversight process are doing a fantastic job at trying to stick to uncovering the facts and getting to the truth. And if you look at the situation with the IRS, I think it is a big concern of a lot of people in this country, because what we've seen is a president who, number one, has said he wasn't connected with the activity, yet the expectation is this is his administration, it's the Obama IRS. And we've just not heard what the truth of the matter is. Meanwhile, the concern is an abuse of power. When you have an administration that somehow supports the notion that you could use a neutral instrument of government like the IRS, a tax enforcement agency, to go after political opponents, that's just unacceptable. That's not what we do.
But I haven't heard anybody in the Obama administration say anything to the contrary. And I'm wondering, what lie do you think Jay Carney told? Or is it okay for Daryl Issa just to call him a liar?
Well, I think that sticking to the facts and trying to uncover what really went on, who knew, who gave the directive for this kind of activity, did the White House know, all of these things is what we're trying to uncover, and cooperation or willingness on the part of the president and his administration to get to the bottom of this, to tell us what went on, in fact, could clear a lot up. And we could go forward making sure it will never, ever happen again.
The Washington Post today had an interesting story about the House Republicans and some of the divisions within it. And there was this one description after a coup attempt, not a very successful one, in January. Speaker Boehner is depicted in the story as barely holding the party together. And there is this passage I wanted to read to you. The leaders have come under intense scrutiny barely 36 hours after the caustic New Year's Day vote. Boehner faced a coup attempt from a clutch of renegade conservatives, the cabal, quickly fell apart when several Republicans, after a night of prayer, said God told them to spare the speaker. I guess that's good news that God told these members to spare the speaker. What can you tell us about the divisions within the Republican Party? I know Speaker Boehner has even acknowledged that sometimes some members of the caucus are a little difficult to control.
Jake, we're a party of ideas. We actually embrace robust debate and dialogue. And you'll see in our agenda what we have done is taken a conference of individuals who are very passionate about the privilege of being a voice for the people and putting that to work to see how we can affect the dream of a more prosperous and more secure America.
That passion, though, somehow sometimes ends up meaning Speaker Boehner almost loses his job or is threatened?
No, I think Speaker Boehner has support without a doubt overwhelmingly in our conference.
You're here today to talk about cosponsor.gov. What is cosponsor.gov?
Cosponsor.gov is an online destination to engender a national conversation about things going on in Washington. And all folks have to do is go click on to cosponsor.gov, and they can become a co-sponsor of any legislation that has been submitted for consideration in the House.
As individuals?
As individuals, and it is all legislation, those supported by Republicans and Democrats. And Jake, it's part of our continued attempt to live up to our commitment to transparency in government. At the end of the day, this is the people's government. Washington ought to be working for the people, not the other way around. And when the people see all of this nonsense going on at the IRS and the administration losing its focus on the people, it's things like cosponsor.gov, which I think come back and say to the constituents we represent that we mean it when we say we're here for you. Please join us in this debate.
All right, Majority Leader Eric Cantor, Republican of Virginia, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Jake.